Hi friends, MD Vegan. I make zucchini noodles today. This is a zucchini. Yeah, it's of the pumpkin family, squash, and it's super healthy. And why I make noodles with this? Because they have this wonderful texture that is like a sponge a little bit, like a dough. And the dough has to be in the noodle, in a regular noodle. They have to be able to soak up the sauce. That's the most important thing with the dough for the noodles. And this is pretty similar. It has this sponge-like texture I show you in a moment. So that is the theme today, zucchini noodle, veggie noodle. And I want to make a pesto today, kind of pesto. Pesto is usually with pine nuts and basil, basically. And then you have some oil and so. But we have also other ways to make pesto. Meanwhile, it's well known now. We have nuts. And for the pine nuts, I take cashews. And for the oil, I take avocado. That's how I make a mayonnaise too. That's basically like a mayonnaise. You know, here, nuts and avocado. With the mayonnaise, I have a little bit of avocado. Here, I have a whole avocado. It's a small one, but it's a whole one. And half a cup of cashews. With the mayonnaise, I would take a little bit less avocado. But with a pesto, a little bit more, because, so avocado and cashews, because the main part of the pesto is the green herbs. That's usually basil, that's the classical one from Italy. But here I have cilantro. I have a whole bunch of cilantro, a large bunch of cilantro with everything. And that goes in last, because in a real pesto, it is not really the cream, like in a mayonnaise. Pesto is more like chunky, but the pine nuts are very soft and the oil is runny, so it's easy to process the pine nuts. And so that's why I take a cashew also soft, but I have to blend it. And the food processor would be too coarse. The pine nuts are so soft, so it's a good boy. And a food processor would be enough for a pesto, because with a blender, you make a cream right away. It's very fast and powerful. And so I will not put the cilantro in right away. I put it in later and pulse only with the bzz, 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 you know, pulsing. But first I make it creamy with the cashews and the avocados. And the seasoning is very simple here. I have a lime. Yeah, that is very nice with the cilantro. And I have also chili powder, that is bird's eye chili, that is very hot, or medium hot, so I don't take that much. I have salt, classic, and garlic. That's also for pesto, pretty usual, all this. Of course, with the basil, you take the pepper maybe rather than chili, and you take also maybe lemon or vinegar or both for basil. But here, for the cilantro and the avocado, I take chili and lime. So I have lime here. But I don't put in all the lime because it might be too sour. Yeah. I will see, I begin with half a lime and 2 cloves garlic, teaspoon salt, and a half teaspoon of the chili powder. So that always half of the lime remains for seasoning later. And some water to begin. I can always adjust a little bit. Pesto is not really runny. Pesto is more a mousse. A little bit chunky mousse. Yeah, because the herbs are really the main part, comes later. So first I get the base here, blender dance. You can also hear it, the blender, the sound goes up. That means it's a little bit, I need a little bit more water, but I won't put it in now because I don't want it. I don't want to have it too runny and too thin. I wanted to break it down first So now the nuts, the cashews have been broken down and the other ingredients. It can now sit for a moment and soak. And then I will put in the herbs in a moment. But first, let me taste it. Tastes wonderful. Oh, really nice. Very nice. Yeah, it's strong. I'm thinking about how about a little bit more lime. That comes later. Now let it sit for a moment. And then we go to the next step. So first part, prepare the pesto. And now I do the zucchini noodles. That's the main part. Second main part. Okay. And for this I take spiralizer. And the spiralizer has a car here. Yeah. And to push the zucchini to the blade. And then there is the blade here. Some fantastic principle here. You have two blades at the same time. This is the blade here, and this is the noodle maker. Both together, first it gets cut, and then it is shaped. Yeah. Interesting. And here you fix the noodle of the zucchini, and here you fix it, and then you push it to the blade, and spiralize away. And well, this is a very good spiralizer. It's not very expensive, 20, 30 bucks. But you can get now many, many. When I bought it decades ago, there were not so many, and I didn't really know what to take. But nowadays, I heard there are a lot of spiralizers. You can get any one as you like. They're all pretty cool. So no problem, man. They're not that expensive. It's a wonderful tool. You have this one has different blades. You can make broad and thin and thick noodles. For zucchini, I take a little bit of thicker noodle because the zucchini also releases water. So when you make it very thin, the noodles can be not thick. It's a thin one. They can release a little bit of water. Okay, that is something I tell you later about. But if the noodle is too thin, or now let's put it differently. So the noodle will anyway release water. So either if it is a thin or thick is not really the problem. The problem is I was wrong with that. The problem is that the dressing should not be too runny. Yeah, if it depends what you want, but it can be runny good too. But then you have a soup more like. But this dressing will not have too much water. So even if the noodles release some water, as they would naturally by their nature, this is still a nice dressing. So but I have to do now is I have to put the spiralizer on a firm ground. That's why I took the cutting board away. It's made from wood. I need something better for the feet to be firm, because I have to push the wagon, the car, so it has to be firm on the ground. So put the bowl so the noodles are caught. And here now I have to prepare the zucchini. That's very easy, because here you see it's a little bit round, and has to be both sides have to be parallel to fit into the blender or to the spiralizer. So just here, make it parallel here, one side, mm-hmm. and the other side parallel almost. Right. So let's see if that works. The large side goes into the. And the zucchini should not be too old, because when they get old and soft, the spiralizer might have a little problem with them. So the fresh and crunchy zucchini is the best. Now let's see if it works. It looks good. Yeah. Spiralizing away works. Yeah. Fix the spiralizer on the ground again. And now we go. I'm lucky my zucchini is fresh enough. The noodle's coming out nicely. I'll show you in a moment. There we go. See? Yeah, put it into the bowl right away. Get some of the remaining noodles out of the cutter. That's it. That was the spiralizer. The job is done. So now, this is in this inside of the spiralizer. a little bit of remnant, but you can put it in a dressing or so, you don't need to throw it away. So now I go back to my cutting board, and the board goes back to the place, and now I put the noodles on here. That's the noodles here, I show you by the way. Long noodles here, you see, they're long, and if you want to have it long for the children or so, they like long noodles to play. But I prefer them to have a little bit shorter. No children around right now. So what I do is I take a chef's knife and cut it crosswise, so that's enough. So I have it in the right size, mouth bite size. So I can put it in the mouth easily. So that's it. That's my noodles now. See? They're beautiful. Noodle texture. It's a wonderful way, but because pumpkins and squash and these zucchinis are super healthy. Yeah, wonderful. Very healthy. So much benefits. One of the healthiest foods we have. Now I go back to my dressing, the pesto. I'll taste it one more time to see if I can put it in a little bit more lime. It's thick, so maybe a little bit too thick. It's a little bit chunky. Good. A little bit more, just another quarter, and a little bit more. One more short blend. Just to break it down a little bit, because it can be a little bit chunky, so we have some nuts in there, these soft nuts at least. The cashews are nice for that. It doesn't matter. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good. Okay. Now, time for the cilantro. Let's see it pulsing. I have to push it down a little bit. Should work. Pulsing. Yeah, it's still a little bit chunky, maybe too chunky. Yeah, a bit too chunky. But the flavor is nice. Yeah. So I blend a little bit. Maybe careful, yeah. Shouldn't be too chunky and not too little. That's in the middle. I have to play a little bit. Let's see. You're getting there. Texture is nice. It looks almost like a pesto. Good. Okay. I'd say we got it. So, now to the noodle. Noodles. I have a certain second ingredient here for the noodles, otherwise I could just take the noodles and put the dressing and pesto over, would be it. Instead I take a second ingredient here. It makes it a little bit more exciting. I have one chili pepper. Cut that into slices, and you see inside the slices here, you have the seeds. You can see that the seeds are still in there. And they can be very hot. So if you have a very hot chili pepper, you want to take out the seeds. It's very easy. Yeah, lengthwise, cut it open, scrape it out, and then you slice it anyway. But this is not such a hot chili pepper. I take some, I keep some for decoration. Put the chili, the chilies into the noodles. See, and now I put the pesto on top. I only see I won't take too much pesto. I have to be now a little careful, not too much. I don't want to drown the noodles. So begin with the main part. We'll toss it now. Looks nice. Yeah. And now it's about tuning the amounts. You know, how much pesto do I need? Well, so far it looks not bad. Doesn't look bad here. Maybe it's enough. So I have left a little bit of pesto for the next portion, for the next zucchini. Or other noodles. I can also make other noodles. Not only zucchini. I can take carrots. But let's see if that would work. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I can take a little bit more. Oh, I was not so wrong with my measurements. I can take it all. Yeah, that's nice. It's not a very fat pesto. There's no oil. Avocado is a healthy fat. Cashews also healthy fat. So have a little bit more of the pesto here. Won't make it too heavy. You cannot eat too much fat from nuts, by the way, if you have the whole nut. That is a very good news. But here it is. Here is my zucchini with cilantro, cashew, avocado pesto. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. If you like my video, subscribe MD Vegan on YouTube. Have another recipe every single day. And find me on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, and Twitter.